What is happening, guys? Cowboy here, and welcome back to NieR Automata. So, after the last episode, picked up one additional side quest somebody was offering, just to show you guys that real fast. Just photographs of various places I've been. I'll get that later, not worried about it for now. For now, we're going down into the big old hole in the ground. So, obviously, last episode asked you guys to leave in the comments below what you wanted to see for my next pod. That's not going to be in this episode. Obviously, I don't have enough feedback yet. I mean, this episode's only a couple hours after. But we will see whatever y'all wanted coming on Monday. So definitely make sure to let me know down in those comments if you haven't yet. For now, we're going to mess around with Mirage on this episode. Make our way down into the big old hole.
What is this?
Analysis. It is a cave-in caused by the collapse of an open space underground.
Why is there such a huge cavern beneath the city?
Let's see how well this works. Oh my god, that is so fucking cool. Oh my god. That pod. It's basically Omni Slash! Oh my god, why have I not used this since I started playing the game? Oh man. Oh, I'm so happy with that. I mean, it looked cool, and oh man, was I right. It is so fucking good. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know if Spear or Hammer can really compare to how badass Mirage is. I mean, Mirage definitely seems like it's gonna be intended more for AoE situations, you know, grouped up by a bunch of enemies, pop that out, just wreck everything. Whereas Laser is more for ranged fighting. I mean, Hammer is going to be my big single target. But Spear, at least based on the look of Spear, looked like it would serve a similar function to that of Mirage with, like, the AoE. So I'm kind of curious what makes Spear different. I don't know, maybe if it adds a stun mechanic onto the enemy as well.
That's a weird-looking enemy.
It's just the sewer from before. To be surfing. Super surfing! I think this just leads me back to the amusement park. Man, think about all the shit and piss that's getting into her shoes right now. Them heels are ruined. Where is this even going? Where did I just gain access to? Oh, wandering couples over here. Well, I mean, since we're over here, might as well just run by and say hello. And then we are gonna go do the flooded city stuff for reals. For reals this time. Bunch of people dying around here, apparently. What's up, y'all? Yeah, no, fuck off. 50,000 gold. Y'all can eat a dick. I mean, I'm sure there's like some badass reward you get for doing that, but for starters, I don't have 50 grand right now to give them. And on top of that, I'm totally going to Google what the reward is before I just hand over 50,000 gold. Because as far as I'm concerned, they can eat a big old oil-covered android dick if they think they're going to get 50,000 gold. Going out into the desert and finding them apart, that's one thing. Giving you 50 grand, no. Sorry, pumpkin, it looks like you're going to be staying here. Or you're going to be making a little dingy, and you're going to have a hell of a sail across the ocean to the Emancipator. I know this stuff was not here before, so I'm convinced the shit just randomly respawns. Just completely random placement. Alright, looks like something that's filled with drills and... Ow! Shit! How do I even... God, these things are fucking obnoxious. Holy shit. Those things are obnoxious. Like, super obnoxious. I mean, maybe laser would have worked better there. Maybe hammer would have, considering it's just one small weak point that you gotta hit. But, man, pod could not get enough damage into those damn things. I need to stop collecting all the stuff. Like, this game is bad for me, because, like, I see a shiny, and I feel compelled to get it, and it just, like, randomly shits little shiny stuff out all over the place, and
the ground is caved in.
I have to go
for it.
There must
have been a hollow down there this whole time. This hallway looks pretty old.
Omnia Slasher! Critical up? Oh yeah, baby. Put that on. Is that an item I use? Or what? Impact bracer. I feel like it would be right in here. No, maybe. Did I get a critical up chip? P gain up, damage absorbed, damage avoid, critical up, 1%. I mean, I'm gonna need to level that up to make it worthwhile, I think. Vengeance, auto heal, and max HP. I'll take it. It was this way. Okay, auto heal is just ridiculous. My health just climbed itself back to full. I remember reading something about auto heal and deadly heal. I know deadly heal heals you when you take damage. And if my understanding is correct, auto heal, it's like after you haven't been hit for 4 seconds, it just starts healing, which is fucking awesome. So awesome. So then you just basically need to do a little bit of evade spam and you're all set. Auto heal plus 2. Oh my god. Like, I was right after I'm get done talking about it. She's like, I heard you wanted an auto heal. Here you go. Wow. Wow. That's amazing. Alright, well, I need 10 slots. So, what's coming off? 8% more XP, 2% more XP. You can come off. I like drop rate. I like max HP. Counter. I'm not countering at all. I barely used counter. Definitely. Oh man, I should upgrade these bad boys. Oh shit, what did I just take off? Shockwave plus 1 melee, drop rate, XP gain, auto heal. The max HP. Took you off. I need to unlock the rest of my slots. But I'm going to combine those auto heals so I have like a super auto heal. And actually, let me go this way first. Always cover the alternate paths. Look at the heal! Oh my god, that's so fucking good. Arbitrarily having to use small and medium heals before encounters is no longer a thing. I'm going the wrong way.
Look at all these dead machines. Seems like they've been here for a long time.
All right, at first I didn't believe the whole alien thing. Now I am starting to.
What is this place?
I don't know. There's nothing like it in the database.
Are they dead?
To be. Look!
There were actually aliens.
Destroyed alien motherships.
Welcome to the graveyard of our creators.
Those are the dudes from earlier, the robo-human. Are we fighting?
You.
To be. Look out!
My name is Adam. The aliens you seek are no longer here. They were wiped out centuries ago by us, the machines.
Wiped out?
And who knows? Perhaps we'll wipe out the androids next. Machines are weapons capable of evolution. We can grow. We can become aware. Eventually, the intelligence within our network began to surpass that of our creators. You'd probably be surprised at how quickly it happened.
You destroyed your own creators?
Oh, there's no need to fret about them. They were simple, infantile, almost like plants, I guess you'd say. They held no value to us, but the humans on the moon, now they are interesting.
Why them?
Because they are an enigma. They killed uncountable numbers of their own kind, and yet loved in equal measure. It's fascinating, don't you think? What could possibly drive such behavior? We have dedicated ourselves to unraveling this riddle of humanity. And now we will allow you to assist us. You were made in their image, after all.
Assist you with what?
It's simple. We need you to locate the humans on the moon and bring them to us. We will then dissect and analyze them in order to drag their secrets forth into the light. Surely you see the attraction in this.
Are you insane? We'd never do that! Can you believe this, 2B? This guy's bonkers.
Well, I suppose this concludes negotiations. The only remaining option is to destroy you. The same way we destroyed these aliens.
Time grows short. This year, this is the fate that befell our creators.
As for your beloved humans, I guess we'll see, won't we?
They're gone.
The aliens were already dead.
Yeah. We better get back to the bunker.
I gotta say, this is definitely a turn of events I didn't expect. Like, the aliens came, created machines, machines just annihilated the aliens and said they were simple? Like, what? I mean, this looks like a pretty fucking dope spaceship. Like, I'd say they're not really that simple, but I guess the machines, the AI, was just more evolved than them.
Back this way again? What a pain.
Stop complaining.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I really thought there was going to be some, like, weird curveball, but no, it's pretty straightforward.
Operator 6-0. We now have an operational transporter in the city ruins. We're attempting to deploy them at other points as well.
About time we had access to those.
Care to fill me in?
Transporters? They let you transfer your consciousness to a temporary body back in the bunker. I heard some tech guys talking about it a while ago, but I didn't know they'd finally got it working.
Hey, how's it hanging?
You again.
Your commander told me to build a new access point, so here you go. Oh, and I got the stupid transporter up and running too.
Thank you?
I've known the commander for a while now. She sure is good at pawning work off on people. Next time you see her, give her some lip for me, will ya?
So this has a transporter now, huh?
Still, transporters are pretty handy. They're way faster than flight units when it comes to traveling between Earth and the bunker. Flight units also leave us open to attack, and they're expensive to operate, too.
Oh my god, I have fast travel. Oh, look at all the places I can go, it's amazing! It's like it's storing me in a fridge.
That concludes our report on the events surrounding the alien wreckage. Then they were dead this whole time.
The Council of Humanity needs time to formulate a plan. Until then, this information must be kept confidential. Speak of it to no one.
Of course. Your next mission is to gather additional intel on the individual known as Pascal.
You mean that freaky machine we ran into?
This order comes directly from the Council. Knowledge of such unique individuals is essential for the success of future missions. Understood.
I don't know why she's worried about Pascal. Pascal's not really a threat at all. For real though, the machine's just taking out the aliens.
Commander sure is a slave driver, huh? And now we have to go back to the city ruins.
Thankfully, we can always just fast travel back.
It's been a while.
I'll rest if I feel like it.
Yeah, 9S, stop your crying. He's such a whiny android, man. Your heart terminal. Maybe I need to fuse some stuff. Yeah, 11,000. That's right, I wanted to fuse my auto heals together. Definitely worth doing. I could fuse these. Oh shit, that's a diamond one. I create an auto. Oh damn it, the black went away. I thought black always stays. Well, we're gonna combine them. I mean, gotta have to. So to do that, how much is upgrading pod too? Oh, I don't have the parts for that. Let's sell some stuff. I got some chips that I probably won't use. Let's see where. Drop more money. It sounds good. Fuse together my auto heals. Hang on. It's gonna go 11 to 12. If I select 9 first, it's still gonna go to 12. Bah, whatever. Let's go up to 4.8. I think that's worth it. Damage absorb, I don't really care about. Evade range, I don't really care about. Drop rate up. If I combine this with this, what do I gotta do to retain the diamond? I think I need to have two that have diamonds. Don't I already have? I have a drop rate plus 2 on already. XP gain. I'm gonna keep fusing those because I want to make a really high XP gain. Damage absorb, I'm gonna get rid of. I like the sound of anti-chain damage, but I don't think it's needed. And then the real question is, I need to sell. So you're hanging on to. You're gone. You're gone. I mean, I don't know. I'll wait. I'll find something better. Base counter. Critical up plus 1. I'll sit on those just because they might be useful later. Ranged attack up plus 3 is good. Weapon attack up. That's such a minor upgrade, it's not worth keeping. Melee defense also kind of inconsequential, 10%. And then that space shockwave is good. First thing I gotta do is, let me just sort them out. Customize, where was the... There we go, okay. Nope. No. I wanna go type A, customize all chips. So OS, fishing, damage control, damage values. Where's the XP? I don't see XP in here, XP gauge, there it is, okay. So, range tech up, shockwave max XP, EXP up, auto heal has to go on for sure, drop rate for sure, more experience gain up, and then let's do critical rate by 2%. I think that's good. I still got quite a bit of money. Let's go storage. Yeah, maxing out storage needs to be my priority. So we got rid of some stuff, but I mean, I'm starting to find all much better chips anyway, so I think this is a good loadout. No, I'm not. Whatever, be aggressive. Damn. Well, we're wrapping this one up for here. Moving forward from here, so obviously Dark Souls DLC comes out, and that's going to take up a ton of content creation time, but I'm still really enjoying this, so more than likely what I think I'll do is I'll keep this running as like a two-a-day series, and then I'll probably drop Mass Effect down to a two-a-day series, or maybe even convert that to more of live stream. Like, I think ultimately what's going to happen is one of these games, either this or Mass Effect, is going to get changed to be stream-focused. I think they would both work well for it. I'm not sure which would be better, but I mean, I like both a lot. Like, honestly, I like the combat of this more than Mass Effect. Mass Effect, I'm more playing just because it scratches that itch from the old Mass Effects, you know? But this is just good, new, and fresh, and not giving that up. So, anyway, make sure to stay tuned. I might do a Saturday or Sunday episode with this, because I mean, I'm sure you guys want to know what's happening. You know, now I mean, the machines are killing aliens, we gotta figure out. But anyway, stay tuned, and we'll catch you guys next time.